if the protection was removed out of your life, if that blessing that God has given to you was taken away, what kind of Christian would you be? If right now, today, the protection of God was removed from your life and you lost everything, what kind of a Christian would you be? What if you lost your job? What if you lost your children like Job did? What if you lost your baby? What if you lost your house? What if you lost your spouse? Would you still be a godly person? Would you still maintain your integrity and be upright in the things that you said and do? When your parents pass away, will you maintain your integrity, or are you going to blame God? Listen, you're going to lose friends, you're going to lose things in life, and you have to determine right now the type of Christian you're going to be. Amen. And it should be somebody that is upright, that's afraid of God, that hates evil, that gets evil away from them, and you maintain your integrity. Listen, Jesus said, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Jesus is saying, in the world, you're going to have problems. You'll have trials and tribulation. And the goal here is that we need to determine today that we will have integrity in tribulation when it comes. In 1 Peter 4, he says, beloved, think it not strange concerning the fiery trial, which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened unto you. When you go through bad times, don't, God, this is strange. Why is this happening? Hey, we're spiritual. We are spiritual people. We will go through spiritual trials in life, and sometimes our spirit is tested by the lack or the loss of physical things. And don't think, oh, this is some strange thing, God. Strange things are happening. He says, it's not strange. This is a trial to try you. He says, but rejoice, inasmuch as you are partakers in Christ's sufferings, that when his glory shall be revealed, you may be glad also with exceeding joy. He's saying that when you go through trials as a Christian, you come through as a better person, but also there's an opportunity to do the right thing and be rewarded of God. If you show integrity in tribulation, I believe God will reward you for doing the right thing. There are always people watching you. We don't recognize it. We're not always aware of it. We're not aware that maybe we are a role model for somebody or that somebody is looking up to us, especially when you're having a bad day or going through a low time. You're just thinking, woe is me. Well, you know, why do I have to do all this? Meanwhile, somebody is watching you. They're watching your attitude. They're watching the things you say. They're holding on to your words. They look up to you. And if you can teach them about the victories that you have through trials and tribulations, then I believe God will bless you and reward you. And look, Job lost everything that he had. What was his response? Look at verse 20. Then Job arose and rent his mantle and shaved his head and fell down upon the ground and worshiped. Job literally lost everything he's ever cared about in the physical world. And what did he do? He got down on his face and he worshiped God. He prayed to God. He humbled himself before God. He probably begged him, Lord, spare my life. He probably asked the Lord, Lord, is it me? If so, forgive me. Thank you for what you've given me. Thank you for my wife that's still alive. He worshiped God. He meditated on God. He gave God the honor that he deserved, even though he physically lost everything. Job had the right attitude. Look at the next verse. And said, naked came I out of my mother's womb, and naked shall I return thither. And the Lord gave, and the Lord taketh away, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. In all of this, Job sinned not, nor charged God foolishly. Job had a right heart. Job had integrity in his heart when he lost everything. You know, you think about it. Babies don't come out of the womb with a backpack full of goods, right? They don't have anything they own. And when you go to the grave and they put you in that hearse, they don't have a U-Haul trailer behind that hearse taking all of your stuff with you. You came in with nothing. You're going out with nothing. Don't get so attached to the things in this world that you fail to serve God or that you fail to have integrity through life. Job had the right attitude. God brags on Job. He starts out the entire book by saying this guy was perfect. And again, we know that doesn't mean sinless, but his heart was right before God. That's awesome. This is a good role model. This is a leader we can look to and say, how did he respond in good times and bad?